I'm a first-year PhD student at the Laboratory of Bio and Nanoinstrumentation, and I develop microscopes to look at biological samples with high resolution. My goal at the beginning was to build an instrument that I needed for my own research. And then afterwards, when the instrument was built, some of my colleagues became interested in the project, and we are in an interdisciplinary institute, so it was very easy for me to talk to colleagues in biology, and then we started sharing the research. And progressively it became something more open, more shared, and we could share the instrument in several labs.
Open science is going to be the future of academic research. That has many reasons, and funding agencies all over the world are starting to demand that all research results that are obtained are being made freely available to the scientific community and the general public all over the world.
This is a way that shortcuts some of the delays involved in going through a typical commercialization route and the loss of technology during that long process, and it enriches the scientific community. It's a very direct way of translating research into changes in the community that matter.
As part of what we do in our research, we develop new measurement tools and primarily also instruments. And there was a big barrier between labs adopting our tools, because for them they were big black boxes, they were a bit scary, and they definitely could not build them by themselves. So what we decided to do is we organize workshops here at EPFL, where we invite people from other universities to come and participate.
When people come for a workshop, they receive all the individual parts for assembling one of our microscope heads. After this assembly period, they will go to the lab and test and learn how to use the microscope on their own.
When you build a microscope to share for others, you need to take into account that they will not know the system. So you need to build something that is easy to use, that is properly documented. And in this case, because it is open hardware, we need something that one can build without using too complex instruments that does not require too many tools or too heavy maintenance.
We have three different types of workshop. They all are part of this AFM technology, but they involve different components of the system. The main workshop that we host is a workshop based on the atomic force microscope head. This is essentially the heart of the instrument. Another one is we do workshops building a very small range and very high speed scanners. And lastly, we do workshops on the controller. This is actually working on the electronics and on the software to actually control these instruments.
I came to the Open High Speed AFM workshop here a few years ago. Over the course of the 2 days, we did a lot of testing. So you put something together and you test it. And that was really excellent for us because it means we can take things back to the lab and we can know if something goes wrong, we've got a bit of an idea how to start troubleshooting them ourselves. And any changes we've wanted to make or anything we've needed to do with them, Georg and his students have all been really communicative about how best they would do it or their approaches or sending us details of suppliers. So for me, it was a really immersive and professional experience that left me going away knowing exactly how the thing that I'd just made worked.
I think for me the most interesting part of this workshop is actually to meet people from all over the world, people who are working using the same instrument, but obviously the applications are so diverse, and it's great to learn what they're doing, and we can get ideas from them and they can get ideas from us.
It is a solid foundation for both collaborations and getting citations of your own work.
We are planning in a large network grant now across Switzerland to incorporate more universities and more researchers in this general idea and extend it to other kinds of instruments than we've used already, and even see if these kind of ideas might work for other kinds of technology.
In addition, we feel that this is part of our job anyway, because we're not just being paid to develop technology and develop new knowledge, but we're, as scientists, we have to make that knowledge available to the broader scientific community and the general public. And so this is really at the core of what university research is supposed to do, enabling new discoveries and doing that in an efficient manner.